إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد، كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد، كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we ask His help, and we seek His forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil inside us and from the evil consequences of our bad actions. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves to go astray, no one can guide. I testify that there is no God to be worshipped but Allah, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our master, our teacher, our leader, the Prophet of Allah. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Brothers and sisters, from among the blessings and the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that he was given eloquence, clear speech. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith in al-Bukhari and other in Sahih Muslim, he said, أُعْطِيتُ خَمْسًا لَمْ يُعْطَهُنَّ أَحَدٌ قَبْلِي وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ أُعْطِيتُ سِتًّا لَمْ يُعْطَهُنَّ أَحَدٌ قَبْلِي I was given things that none of the prophets, no one before me was given. And the first thing he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أُعْطِيتُ جَوَامِعَ الْكَلِمِ I was given the blessing of clear speech, eloquence. And so sometimes, or most of the time really, every single word or statement that he uttered, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, carries profound meaning behind it. And one of the perils, one of the most beautiful perils of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a statement that he, it was an advice that he gave to his young cousin, Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu anhuma. And in this advice, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listed a few things. They are considered to be the most important blessings and favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. But a lot of us take these blessings for granted. What are these blessings? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Take advantage of five before five. Take advantage of five before five. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, شبابك قبل هرمك. Your youth before your old age. حياتك قبل موتك. Your life before your death. صحتك قبل سقمك. Your health before you fall ill. غناك قبل فقرك. Your richness before poverty. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وفراغك قبل شغلك. And your free time before you become busy. Let it sink a little bit. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اغتنم. اغتنم. And the word اغتنم is the word that it's used for take advantage. And اغتنم in the Arabic language is a very interesting word. اغتنم means to take advantage of something which is easy to take advantage of. So for example, word ghanam, sheep, in the Arabic language, it's called ghanam. Ghanam, sheep. Ghanam is an animal that it's easy to take control of. When you catch a ghanam, a sheep, it doesn't go anywhere. You know? It's just easier to overpower it. It's easier to slaughter it as well. Similarly, the word ghanima, spoils of war. Spoils of war is, you know, is the things that are left after an army is defeated. You know? There is no further, you know, required to, I'm sorry, there is no any further effort required to obtain these spoils. They are just there. All you have to do is just pick them up. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that these blessings, these favors are given to you. These favors are very accessible. All you have to do is just take it. You didn't pay for them. Some of them you didn't even ask for them. They were given to you. But the real question is, will you be from those who truly benefit from these blessings? I won't be able to, you know, elaborate or finish the entire or talk about the entire hadith, but just that first part, and probably inshallah in the next few weeks we'll finish the hadith. Shababaka qabla hiramik, your youth before your old age. And shabab, young age here, does not really or doesn't just mean your childhood or teenage years. You know, in the Arabic culture, a young person or shab, you know, it goes all the way to 40s. So probably most of us here, most of us in this room right now, you know, this khutbah is directed to you. Your young age is the time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the energy, when you have that energy, when you have this aspiration, when you have the dreams, when you have, you know, goals in your mind, when you have strong will. Yeah. This is the time that Allah and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, stressed on all the time. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stressed on the importance of utilizing these years to benefit you. Because one day you're going to get old, you know? And when you get old, you will not have the same creativity. You will not have the same, you know, same strength. You will not have the same energy. You know, Tom Brady wants to throw the ball until he's 50. It's a joke. It's not going to happen. You'll get old. It's just a stage of our lives, you know? You're not going to stay young forever. What did the poet said? La ilaha illallah. Bakaytu ala shababi bi dam'i ayni. Falam yughni al-buka'u wala an-nahibu. Faya layta ash-shababu ya'udu yawman. Abu al-Atahiyya. Faya layta ash-shababu ya'udu yawman fa ukhbiruhu bima fa'ala al-mashibu. He said, I cried over my youth, tears of blood. But weeping or crying didn't really benefit me with anything. Ya layta ash-shabab ya'ud yawman. I wish that, you know, my youth would come back so I could tell it what old age has done to me. So we all gonna get there if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined for us to get there. Right? So you have to find out your purpose in this life. You have to know what is the purpose, what is your plan, what is, if you have a plan, what is your goal in this life? What is your purpose in this life? I'm sorry, but we weren't created to smoke weed all night long. We weren't created to play God of War and FIFA until, you know, 6 or 7 hours every night, and then get up in the morning and say, bro, life is really unfair. We were created for a higher purpose. We were created, brothers and sisters, as Imam al-Ghazali said, to cultivate the earth. We were created to inherit the earth and leave it as a legacy for those who will come after us. We were created to worship Allah. First, to know Allah and worship Him and be grateful to Him, right? And worship Him mean it doesn't just mean, you know, we pray five times a day, or we're doing our zakat at 2.5, or, you know, we fast in the month of Ramadan, doing hajj if we're capable. It's broader than that. It's a bigger term. Ibadah, as Ibn al-Qayyim said, it's a bigger term for everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased for. So if it's pleased with. And so if you have a goal in your life, and you should have a goal in your life, because you cannot live in life just like, you know, like every day. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "La takun ka'imma'a." Don't be insignificant creature. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. And He put you here in this earth as a khalifa. And He also created other creatures, like cattle. We're not like cattle. Worms. We're not like worms. You know? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated our status. And so we have to respond to that. Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also praised young people who grow up worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them so much that He said that they will be given the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سَبْعَ يُظُلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظُلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظُلُّهُ. 7 people will be given the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On a day, there will be no shade except the shade of Allah. And one of them is شَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. A young man who grow up worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, worship here means everything that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can succeed in your job, school, with you in your relationship, that's success. That's ibadah. You could be changing your child's diaper for the sake of Allah. Hey, that's ibadah as well. Everything in your life could be an act of ibadah if you do it in the right way. And our history, the history of Islam, the history of mankind really, is full of great examples of young people who achieved greatness. Sahaba, like Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, the one who defended Islam right in front of the Abyssinian king. You know, Ja'far on that day gave one of the most beautiful, one of the most compelling description of the religion of Islam. Mus'ab ibn Umayr, the first ambassador of Islam. You know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent him to Medina to deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before he migrated. And he did a great job. And many others, those were young people. Those were in their 20s. Non-Sahaba, Muhammad al-Fatih, the conqueror. A man that who was praised, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised him in his prophecy, and he said, لَتُفْتَحَنَّ الْقُسْطَنْطِينِيَّةِ فَلَنِعْمَ الْأَمِيرُ أَمِيرُهَا وَلَنِعْمَ الْجَيْشُ ذَلِكَ الْجَيْشُ. Constantinople will be conquered. And what a wonderful the leader or its leader will be, and what a wonderful army its army will be. لَتُفْتَحَنَّ الْقُسْطَنْطِينِيَّةِ. Those people, brothers and sisters, are great examples of young people. Muhammad al-Fatih was how old when he conquered Constantinople? 23 or 24. His attempt to conquer the city was number 29. It was 28 attempts before him. Some of them were led by Sahaba, Abu Ayyub al-Ansari. Abu Ayyub. You go to Istanbul now, there is a masjid there called Sultan Ayyub. I just want to meet that guy who put him, who gave him the title Sultan, and just kiss his feet. Because yes, he was a Sultan, a Sahaba, before Muhammad al-Fatih, you know, died in Istanbul. You know, tried to gain that honor. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam honored the leader in the army that will open Constantinople one day. If you look at all these people, you will see that they will share one thing. You know, and that thing is strong will. strong will, azm, himma, great determination. They said that Muhammad al-Fatih, when he was having troubles opening the or conquering the city, and some people around him, they said, you know what, just like your father, just like other people, you know, since the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, since the Sahaba of Rasulullah, it's not happening. Let's just go back. Maybe it's not you. He said, no, I will enter the city and I will sit on its throne or I will die trying. That's my word. That's my solution. 23, 24 years old. But he deserved that honor to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A man of a great determination. A man of a strong will. So brothers and sisters, if you have a goal in your life, if you have a goal in your life, then you should fight for it. You should never give up. No matter how long it's going to take. No matter how many, you know, things that go against you. No matter how many times you get knocked down. You know? Adopt that you know, idea of I'm not going to be down all the time. I'm going to try. I'm going to press forward. I'm going to look for my next victory. I'm going to fight. I will never give up. Wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. The people who succeed in this life are not necessarily the most talented, but they're absolutely the most determined. When they fail, they don't see that as final. They get up and they try again, and again, and again, until they succeed. So have a goal. Don't ever give up on your goal. Plan for that goal. Plan for it. It's impossible to hit a target that you cannot see. Write it down if you have to. Look at it once a week or once a month. Make correction and changes if you have to. Write your own destiny. You know, we Muslims believe that everything is written, which is true. Everything is written about you before you were even born. Years, hundreds and thousands of years before you were born. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't have a goal. That doesn't mean that you shouldn't have a dream that you struggle for. Take the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for example. He planned for everything in his life. Every little thing he planned for. Take the hijrah, for example. The hijrah. An amazing example of planning everything to achieve your goal. He hired a guide. He bought the mounts. He picked Abu Bakr to be the Sahabi. Appointed his son Abdul Rahman to bring him news from Mecca. Appointed Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr, to bring him food and water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have taken the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Mecca to Medina on the back of an angel. But this is for us to know. It's for us to learn, to take heed, to learn from the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right? He planned for everything. Sahl ibn Abdullah al-Tasatturi, he said, planning was an important part of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa And if you have a plan for whatever that goal is, it could be as simple as going to the gym. It could be anything. It could be, you know, success in your school, at work, in your relationship with your spouse or with your children, family members, you know, your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there is anything that you need to change, change it right now. If you try to revive your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and there is somebody that or a group of people or a bad company that you're in that preventing you from that, then it's time to cut them off. It's time to make that decision. If you are in a haram relationship and you cannot really give it up, today is the time. Text or that it's over, I'm done. Because that youth is not going to last forever. whose years of energy and creativity and the strength that you will not last forever. It won't. Just a stage of your life. We're passing by, just like a bus, from one stop to another. That's it, until we reach our final destination. So if there is anything that you need to change to achieve the goal, do it. Don't center yourself to a lifetime of being unhealthy, of being unhappy, of being in a job, you know, that is not really inspiring you anymore. Don't do that. Again, you were created and put on earth as a khalifa. And what is a khalifa? A khalifa is someone who beautifies himself and beautifies the earth and the people around him. You're valuable. You're valuable before Allah. You're valuable before the universe. And so use it when you really have it. Don't waste your youth. Don't waste your time. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن ولا. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما انفعنا وزدنا علما. صل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الحمد لله. So brothers and sisters, as we said, the people who succeed in this world are not necessarily the most talented, but they are definitely the most determined in this life. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. You know, those who plan, those who won the akhirah, and they plan for it, they do everything to achieve that goal, right? وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنْ. They are truly, you know, believers. أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. Their endeavors will be thanked, will be praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who will be successful in this life and the next life. Allahumma ameen. May Allah make us among those who acknowledge the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who show gratitude for these blessings and utilize it in the right way. Allahumma ameen. اللهم اجعل هذا الجمع جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا حولنا ولا خلفنا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم من ولي من أمر المسلمين أمرا فرفق بهم فارفق به ومن اشتد عليهم فاشدد عليه. الحمد لله. I just want to thank the people who checked on me or sent me emails or text messages when I was ill. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve your life, keep you safe and healthy and sound, you and your family. Allahumma ameen. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy in our families and bless our children. Allahumma ameen. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our community and all communities. Allahumma ameen. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from anxiety and from grief and from laziness. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from laziness. Allahumma ya Rabbi. Allahumma ya Rabbi. We ask you to protect us from laziness and inability. Allahumma ameen. آمين آمين آمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واسألوه يعطكم واستغفروه يغفر لكم. أقم الصلاة.